right, let's bring in Oliver Sloup from Blue Line Futures in Chicago. Thanks for joining the show today, Oliver. We've got a lot going on outside of our markets, but generally speaking, I'd say we're kind of holding up pretty well. Maybe not holding up pretty well. We're reacting less and less to it. That's probably a better thing to say.
Yeah, I think that's a good way to put it. When you look at the outside markets, the equity markets and the energies, specifically crude oil, natural gas has been relatively strong, but crude oil getting whacked as well. And the grain market's really shrugging off a lot of that uncertainty, which is, I guess, out of the norm. A lot of times when you see volatility in other markets, it changes the money flow in a lot of markets, and it has funds repositioning elsewhere, i.e. the agricultural space, but we're not really seeing that volatility pour into the markets today. That's not to say that it won't come through the remainder of the week. We're right up against technical resistance in this March corn contract. The mid-590s has been a hurdle. We have been unable to get out above. If we can, there's room to run. There's a technical breakout potential up towards 620, but from a risk-reward perspective, we like selling against resistance with a really tight leash, thinking that we could back off here towards the holidays and end of the year.
Yeah, real quick before we go to break, I mean, with crude oil off $4.50, this corn is really holding up. I mean, obviously that's going to affect ethanol, and then obviously it goes on to corn. But I think it smells like it wants to make a run at those levels you were talking about.
Yeah, it definitely does. The thing that concerns me, and I'm a contrarian by nature, is the fact that everybody I know and listen to is looking for a technical breakout above $6. And when everybody is in agreement, that's when my caution flags start to go up. So I'm a little bit skeptical that we're going to be able to do it just yet. That's why we like the risk reward to the sell side. Obviously, a break and close above $6, we're taking our medicine and moving on.
I think that's an excellent way to put it, because when everybody gets on one side of the boat, it doesn't really hugely work out.